To many, recess is a classic part of the school day, time to just be kids.
The rest of the day, they're told who to sit next to and how to sit and where to stand and when to stand. The recess time is the time when they really have a break from that.
But not all kids in the U.S. get equal access to recess every day. Dr. Kathy Ramstetter, a founding member of the Global Recess Alliance, says sometimes recess gets replaced with more class time, or recess is taken away as a punishment. But studies show that kids who are more active are actually better learners and perform better academically.
We could look at Japan, South Korea, and Finland as countries that consistently perform at the top of the world in academics and mandate and allow for 60 plus minutes a day of outside time in recess. And so the idea that recess and academics aren't compatible, the data just don't support.
Dr. William Massey, a professor at Oregon State University who researches the intersection of play and child development, says some states are now putting more emphasis on recess, passing new legislation just this year. Daily recess is currently mandatory in only 12 states.
Studies have shown that children who get more than 20 minutes a day of recess are more on task in the classroom than kids who don't get that 20-minute marker.
And it's not just about the amount of time allotted for recess, but the quality of that break in the day, a problem often affecting children at under-resourced schools.
You know, is it just a barren blacktop with chain link fence around it and nets that aren't even there on basketball hoops? We have to think about how we resource the schools, how we train and prepare monitors, how we organize this space, and that we maximize the use of the resources that we do have, and we find other ways to really pay attention to the way we put recess together.
Experts say the best way to find out if your child is having quality recess each day is to ask them. And if you're not satisfied with that answer, link up with other parents and community members through the PTA and Facebook groups.
A lot of recess legislation that's happened over the past 10 years, parents have been the driving force. Parents understanding that they are a powerful lever is an important thing.
Morgan Norwood, ABC News, New York.
Hi, everyone. George Stephanopoulos here. Thanks for checking out the ABC News YouTube channel. If you'd like to get more videos, show highlights, and watch live event coverage, click on the right over here to subscribe to our channel. And don't forget to download the ABC News app for breaking news alerts. Thanks for watching.